For 50 years, Coronation Street has provided the nation with some of television's most memorable stunts. None greater than the 50th anniversary tram disaster. Here's a look back at some of them. The great, the good, and the not so good over the last half century. A packed Rovers as usual, and some old familiar faces. But no doubt trouble isn't far away. Here it comes. Sound familiar, anyone? You know, there's an old saying in television, and that show don't tell. Just a pity no one told the producers back in 1967. Did anyone see what just happened? I know I didn't. Thank goodness we've learned a few things over the past 50 years.
And I thought, who would look absolutely...
12 years on, and apparently we haven't. Annie Walker might have just knitted the most hideous jumper for poor baby Tracy, but outside, and more importantly off-screen, it seems something terrible has just happened. I thought this was supposed to be a show about stunts. Those sound effects were pretty impressive, though. And although we might have missed the crash itself, again, Hilda Ogden's on the scene. So we won't have to wait long to find out what actually happened.
Who's up there?
There's a young Terry Duckworth there in his gym jams. You go for it, Terry.
That's the woman, Andy. Is that the room?
That's the room, mate, yeah?
But at least there's a little bit more money in the budget for some actual flames by the time a fire hits the Rovers. And Kevin's certainly a brave man. I mean, check out the moustache and the mullet. Well, the 80s has a lot to answer for. And down below, the Rovers burns. Is that Bet Kevin's trying to save? Looks more like Darth Vader to me. There's a chance to see what the special effects guys are really capable of.
Get in the car!
What is it with Coronation Street and trams? Here's another famous stunt involving, yes, you've guessed it, a tram. Only this time the action moves from Weatherfield to the sunny seaside town of Blackpool. Just a pity the poor Rita won't have time to take in the sights. That Alan Bradley was a bad, bad man. Nice raincoat, Rita, by the way. I think they're back in fashion now. Not.
The ring police!
In this clip, we see Alma pay the price for one of Mike Baldwin's scams going wrong. And over 15 million of us tuned in to see if she'd survive this taxi ride from hell.
You liar! Liar!
Better think twice next time you want to book streetcars.
No!
Looks like we got a bit of a floater there. Never a show to miss a trick. This is the second time producers decided to end a major storyline with a rather soggy ending. And who can forget Richard Illman, eh?
I love you!
If this isn't love, then I don't know what is. We love you too, Richard. Thanks for the memories. Now this next clip. Well, it's got it all. Stunts galore. And plenty of gore, and the occasional gurn. Gotta love those producers at Coronation Street. When they decide to kill off a baddie, they don't mess around. Steady, steady, don't jump the gun. She isn't dead yet. Told ya. Too late. You should have been wearing your seatbelt, Maya.
Come on!
And not to be outdone, bad boy Tony Gordon returns to the street in fiery fashion. And we're not talking about his new line in lingerie at Underworld. Tony's back for Carla. But if he can't have her, then nobody can. Nice plan, mate. Just a pity it didn't work out. So Tony is toast. But is this the best stunt we've ever seen on Coronation Street? Down the years, we've had our fair share of excitement. But we think we've saved the best to last in this little walk through some of the best stunts we've ever seen. Thank you. We'll all have our favourite, that's for sure. But one thing's for certain. It's going to be great looking forward to another 50 years of explosive action on Coronation Street.